Yeah, I mean, the way the format was this year, with the first two rounds being on Saturday and then five rounds being on Sunday, it was more of, instead of a draft night, it was 7:15 in the morning, getting out of bed, watching the first couple picks of the third round roll off the board, not really knowing what was happening. I mean, I had kind of heard that once the first four quarterbacks were kind of off the board, anything could happen after that. So to finally get that call, I got the call from Coach Belichick about 10 picks before it happened. So, and I didn't really tell anybody I was sitting in the room with. I just sat down and waited for it to happen. It was pretty cool. But after that, ever since then, I mean, things haven't really slowed down since. So it's been a journey already. The first 10 minutes of it was almost like a job interview. I mean, he wanted to hear my answers on what it would be like, or would I be able to come in and work hard, even though I'd be behind a guy like Tom, and to know that I'm going to thrive in whatever role that I may have, be a leader of the young guys coming in, of the rookie class, and he wanted to hear what I had to say about all that. And then finally, after all that, he said, well, all right, we're going to go ahead and take you here at 94, and I got to talk to the owner, some other people, and it really didn't set in until my name flashed up on the screen, because I had heard horror stories of guys getting the call, and then the team makes a last-minute decision, and they take somebody else, so I didn't really want to kind of jump ahead. Yeah, rookie mini camp was the following weekend, and got out there, and kind of they like to throw the playbook at you and kind of submerge you in it and kind of overwhelm you a little bit, see how you'll handle it, especially when it's just us rookies out there. And it was definitely that. I mean, an NFL playbook is three or four times more intense and kind of in-depth than a college playbook. That's just because the type of guys you're playing against and the defenses you play. But the whole coaching staff, I mean, everything about the Patriot organization is just top class, first class, and they really know how to do things on a day in and day out period to win football games, and you just want to get on board with what they're doing and try not to miss a beat. I think it was that first practice, kind of putting that Patriot helmet on and going out to practice and just seeing Coach Belichick walk out and the first time he came over and was disgusted with something I did or didn't like something I did, and it was kind of neat to do that. Now, I mean, now that whole side of things is kind of rubbed off, and now it's just a hunger to get better every day and just be a part of something special there. I actually just came back home and I was out there for about 5 weeks and kind of really got to start experiencing the culture and getting to know a lot of people and spending a lot of time with my teammates and stuff and had a couple veteran mini camps and the one thing about New England is a lot of the veterans are there the entire off-season program, so getting to train side by side with those guys and see the way they do things. It's just, I mean, it's a blessing, and it's something that I don't think a lot of other organizations can offer to their rookies. Yeah, I mean, I had the privilege of my senior year kind of having Coach Long and Coach Miller and a lot of the other offensive coaches kind of give me a little bit more to handle and put a lot on my plate, which kind of prepared me for what I'd be facing this year. And I think the situation that they put me in and the way they prepared me to play last year gave me every bit of the advantage that I needed to do whatever I could to have an opportunity at the next level, and I owe them a tremendous amount of thanks for all that and the program in general. I mean, Coach Long and the staff, you can tell every single day there's more momentum building and there's young guys getting better and more people are wanting to take notice of this program. And I mean, we've been right around the corner from something special for a while, but people got to realize that it takes rolling up your sleeves and going to work and kind of working through the bumps and just improving every day. It doesn't just happen by a couple good weeks of work. It takes a unique guy to be able to start as a freshman. I mean, I think Ryan is just that. I think he has the work ethic and he understands preparation and leadership and the intangibles that it takes to play quarterback at this level and any level after that. I mean, everybody can throw the ball. Everybody can make plays. It's just a matter of consistently doing it and getting your teammates to perform at a high level. And I think he's going to be able to do that along with the other quarterbacks who's ever in there. They got three very good guys. And the defense, is going to be kind of the stronghold of the team early on. They might have to be. But I think guys like Russell and Luke and and that secondary, Corey Boudreaux coming back. It's gonna be fun to watch those guys. Kind of, I think it's gonna remind a lot of Aztec fans of the old days with guys like Kirk Morrison and Marvell Underwood and Matt McCoy. So.
Cool.